Hello, namaste learners. Today we are going to see preparation of suppositories. There are basically four methods of preparation of suppositories that we are going to see one by one. The first is hand rolling method, next is fusion or heat method, third is compression method, fourth is automated molding machine method. Okay, so first hand rolling method. In that we require a suppository base. The suppository base we have to mix with the medicament which is already powdered and sieved through a sieve. Then we have to make to a proper consistency. We have to remove that suppository base and medicament mixture, and we have to roll out that on a tile on which a butter paper is placed. Okay. After rolling that mixture, we have to cut the suppositories into suitable size and shape, and that will be ready to use. So that is easy method, but problem or disadvantages related to this method is contamination is too possible in this method. So to avoid that, we can go for the fusion method, in which the melt suppository base that is taken, or you can take suppository base and in a beaker and you have to melt that. To the molten mass of suppository base, we have to add finely powdered and sieved medicament. The mixture we have to prepare. The uniform mixture, when it is formed, we have to pass that into the mold. We have to pour that into the lubricated mold, which is already lubricated with the some oil or lubricant. Then we have to keep that into the freezer, and after certain period of time we can collect that. The link I will provide in the description box. You can check the animation related to this. So in this method, we can take our suppository base. We have to melt that, the molten mass that is heated and mixed with the your powder. The molten mass and mixture of the powder with the suppository base, we can pour into the molds. Then the suppository mold that are placed into the freezer, and finally we will get the suppository from the mold. Obviously we need to take care that the suppository mold should be lubricated if your suppositories are getting stick to the suppository mold. Next method is compression molding method, that the cold compression technique that is used, where the medicament is thermolabile. We cannot go for heating method. So in that case, what we do, we prepare the mixture of the suppository base and the medicament. The prepared mixture we have to place into the cylinder. Then the whatever mixture that is placed, we have to push that with the help of piston into the mold, which is to the next or the another end. So the mold, it will go upside and the prepared mass that will be filled into the molds. There is a stop plate which will control the weight or filling of the molds. Okay, later the suppositories can be ejected from the ejection point, that is E. This process is continued until we get the n number of suppositories. This is the machine that can be used for compression molding. In that case, these are the molds that are used, and this is the machine which is used for the hand molding or hand press for compression molding. This is automated molding machine, in which there is a container or a vessel in which suppository base plus powder that is added. It is heated and there is obviously requirement of stirrer. The molten mass then that is passed through to the suppository molds or suppository having a shape of suppository part of machine. Later we can collect that suppositories from the another end. In automatic molding machine method, instead of using the molds, we can directly put the packaging also. So the fill-in package suppositories we can get, In that case, the two sheets of suppository packaging that is taken, that will run on the two different rollers, and from center we can pour the mixture of suppository base and medicament, and later so we can seal that and we will get suppository inside the package itself. Okay, next, the suppository molds that are made up of either the stainless steel, brass, aluminium, etc. But nowadays you can see the plastic molds and in package molds are also available that are better suitable for preparation methods. Lubrication of molds that is carried out with the help of different lubricants. For cocoa butter, the common preparation of lubricant that is used is consisting of a soft soap 10 gram, glycerin 10 gram, alcohol 90% 50 ml. The mixture is prepared and that is used for lubrication purpose. Then for glycerogelatin base, you can use either liquid paraffin or RHS oil or any other oil you can use. For synthetic and emulsifying bases, we usually not require lubricant, but if you require, you can use the oils. The calibration of molds that we'll see in the next part in detail. That is, the standard molds are of usually 1 gram capacity. Size of suppository is same, but weight varies due to density differences. So we need to prepare dummy suppositories for calibration and finding average weight indicating the true capacity. The differences that comes because of the density differences between the suppository base and the medicament. So because of that, although the suppository molds are prepared or they are having standard of 1 gram, 2 gram, etc. But then also actual or final weight of suppository that varies because of the differences in the density. Then we'll see general method of preparation of suppository. In that, the first we required to calculate the required quantities of the different ingredients that are required for preparation of suppositories. In that case, we have to take additional extra two samples so that the final weight that would be made up. Then we have to select a dry and clean mold. We have to place that on a clean tile. Then weigh and place the required quantity of base in a evaporating dish. The finely powdered drug, which is passed through sieve number 180 or of any other suitable sieve, which will give us uniform size particles. We have to weigh the powder and we have to add that powder into the hot tile which we have to heat, and then to that tile the melt base 2/3 contents and rest melt with the stirring. So in a beaker where we have taken the suppository base, we have to melt two-thirds of the contents of the suppository base, and the remaining will get molten along with the first one or the initial part of the suppository base. Then out of the molten mass of the suppository base, we have to add half of the portion to the tile, okay, where we have kept our powder, and we have to levigate on powder itself. If that is getting solidify, then in that case you can heat the tile again. Then this mixture is again transferred to the evaporating dish, and from evaporating dish we have to transfer that into the molds. Okay, so these molds we have to keep for certain period of time, that is for 2 to 3 minutes, and after that we have to remove the excess quantity of the mixture using a sharp knife. Then to solidify, we have to keep that in a freezer for 10 to 15 minutes. And finally, we can collect the suppositories from the lubricated molds by opening the suppositories. Okay. So next point is packaging and storage. Cocoa butter suppositories are individually wrapped in lubricated butter paper arranged separately in partition box to prevent contact or adhesion. Box is usually made up of hardboard plastic and it must be of sliding type. Glycerogelatin suppositories are generally packed in tightly closed container, as we know that absorbs the moisture. So to prevent moisture absorption, suppositories with light sensitive material or drugs can be packed into the metallic foil or a black colored sheet, okay, so that it will be kept away from the light. So this is the figure that shows the storage. Storage should be below 30 degrees Celsius and protected from the light. This is the label that you can prepare in this way. So labeling that requires storage in the cool place. So we have to store the suppositories during its sale and distribution into the freezer, preferably. Macrogol suppositories, they may not require the freezer storage. You can keep that on the room temperature, at room temperature also. Similarly, we need to add rectal use only, vaginal use only, or urethral use only, such label for the suppositories which are meant for that particular purpose. Next, we have to also label the quantity of ingredients, manufacturing date, expiry date, direction, and the other necessary requirements that usually we write on the label, that is the place of manufacturing, etc. This is the label that you can see, say clindamycin phosphate equivalent to clindamycin 100 milligram, clotrimazole 200 milligram, excipient QS. It also contains approved colors, so along with that, indication, dosage administration, manufacturing, manufactured by, marketed by, if there is storage requirement, say cool dry place, protect from light, keep out of reach from the children, then schedule requirement, then these are vaginal inserts, so not for use, manufacturing license number, date, expiry date, then the price. These are the parameters that are written on the sample label that you can use for packaging. What are the factors that affect the administration of the suppositories? In that, there are three different types of factors. First is physiological factor, second is physicochemical factors related to the base, and third one is physicochemical factors related to the drug. Okay, so first we'll see physiological factors. So in relation to the rectal suppositories, we place the suppositories through rectal route. So colonic contents that plays important role. The colon should be clear, the region from where you are inserting the suppository, it should be clear of any material or matter. The circulation time, the amount of blood that reaches to that rectal region, the injury, the physiological condition, that also matters in the absorption. The pH of the rectal region or vaginal region where we are administering the suppositories, that also we need to take care of, as there is a limited amount of liquid which is present in that area, which has limited buffering capacity. Then physicochemical factors related to the suppository base, in that melting and setting point of the suppositories, मेल्ट होने के लिए और सेट होने के लिए टाइम लगता है, उस दोनों का जो डिफरेंस होगा वो कम से कम हो. दी सपोजिटरी बेस, इट मस्ट बी कॉम्पेटिबल, स्टेबल, इट शुड हैव बेटर वाटर एब्सॉर्प्शन कैपेसिटी, विस्कोसिटी शुड बी प्रॉपर, देयर शुड बी नो ब्रिटलनेस ऑन द स्टोरेज. देन दी फिजिकोकेमिकल फैक्टर्स रिलेटेड टू द ड्रग, सॉलिबिलिटी ऑफ द ड्रग, that we have to check. The particle size of the drug should be less and it should be uniform. Density of that material we have to check, because that is important parameter in calibration of the suppository molds. The nature of base we have to select according to the drug, and the other adjuvants we may require in certain cases. The evaluation of suppositories can be done by the different parameters. First one is
organoleptic characteristics that you can check the color, odor, shape, size, etc., and texture also. Melting range, for that you can use the melting range apparatus, in which we can check the melting range of the suppositories. Then the softening and liquefaction time, in that the time just required to get softened or to liquefy, as well as to liquefy, that is checked. So these are two different time points that we have to note, how much time is required. Mechanical strength, hardness, that also can be checked with the in-house instruments in the industry. Then the content of the package dosage forms, it should be between the limit of 90 to 102% as per the pharmacopoeia. Then uniformity of weight, it is allowed within the range of 5% from the average weight. Then for uniformity of drug content, we have to take 10 suppositories, and the drug content or assay should be in between 85 to 115%. If one or two suppository that goes beyond that limit, then we have to repeat that test with the 20 additional suppositories as per pharmacopoeia, and the out of 30, one it is okay, but if more suppositories that go beyond the limit, it should not be beyond 75 and 125%. And finally, stability also we need to check, in that all parameters are checked during the short term and long term testing. Short term testing, that goes usually up to 6 months, and long term testing, that may be continued up to 3 years during the shelf life. Okay, so next is disintegration test. For that purpose, a special apparatus that is developed, in which the pharmacopoeial apparatus, in which we have to place the suppository here, and we have to heat that suppository, in that we have to perform disintegration into that apparatus. The temperature is 36 to 37 degrees Celsius. The volume of the media which is used for disintegration test is 4 liter. After each 10 minutes, we have to check the suppository whether they have completely dissolved, dispersed, or they have become softened. And we have to note the point at which that becomes completely dissolved, dispersed, or it softens. And that point will be the disintegration point or disintegration time. The dissolution that is done either by basket apparatus or using flow through cell. So in basket you can place your suppositories, or in a flow through cell we can keep our suppository, and a dissolution media that is passed, and that will be continuous process, and we have to collect the sample, how much amount of drug that is released. Similarly, with the basket apparatus, we remove the sample at periodical intervals and we'll check the amount of drug that is released. So these are the some references and additional resources that you can go through, and these are referred for this presentation. So thank you. You can subscribe, share, and like to this video if you like. Okay. Happy learning.